In this video, we're going to review when and why targets might be needed when capturing data with the BLK360. From this picture, you can see that targets come in all shapes, sizes, and variants. Many manufacturers like targets where the pattern makes an X. This is because these targets have a distinct center point where the other shapes, like spheres, the center point can vary due to wear and tear and/or environmental conditions. There are two major reasons why targets might be needed on your project. The first is targets in the data can be used to rotate and translate the point cloud into a project or local coordinate system. This is helpful when BLK360 data needs to be brought into a CAD drawing and the point cloud and the drawing or model need to match. The second reason targets might be needed is if data is being collected along a long linear corridor like this hallway, where it has very little distinguishing features, or very repetitive features like in this parking garage. Sites like these are extremely problematic for automatic cloud-to-cloud registration routines. In fact, sites like these have a very high probability of failure when registering without target help. By introducing targets on sites like these, it introduces reference points so that the different BLK360 positions can be properly stitched together. When using targets, proper placement is key, as well as the number of common targets between BLK360 positions. Having three common targets is the minimum number of targets needed between scans that will be stitched without the benefit of a cloud-to-cloud constraint. Having a fourth target is nice in case one of the targets does not acquire correctly in the software, and having a fifth target is best as it solves for all 6 degrees of freedom of 3D space. Also note the shape of the targets. Avoid placing targets all at the same height as this creates a weak geometric shape which could yield poor registration results. Once all your targets are placed, conduct your data collection.